how do we apply finger teaching in our classrooms? For older learners, say 10, 11, 12, you can actually ask them to do the challenge, okay? Coordination, okay? Ini koordinasi mata dan tangan. Are you ready? T-R-E-A-S-U-R-E.
T-R-E-A-S-U-R-E.
Okay, I'm going to challenge you. Who can do this? T-R-E-A-S-U-R-E.
Do you like you?
What's the next one after S?
You.
So go on, Bintang, let's try with you. Do you still remember?
T-R-E-A-S-U-R-E.
There you go. Well done. Okay. Alvin, are you ready? Go.
T-R-E-A-S-U-R-E.
There. Well done. Okay. Ahsan, your turn. Ready?
T-R-A-A-S-U.
Wait. Is it T-R-A-E or T-R-E-A?
A-E.
Guys, check it again.
I-A.
I-A or E-A?
E-A.
E-A. T-R-E-A.
T-R-E-A-S-U-R-E.
Yay, there you go. T-R-E-A-S-U-R-E. A lot of learners. So, for older learners, you can always challenge them to spell the word correctly. Do we have to do that in every spelling session? No, it doesn't necessarily so. You can do that as an intermezzo, something to make it more fun for them. They are children anyway. So let them play and learn at the same time. Don't push it too hard for them to learn English.